30th President of the United States, Calvin Coolidge, and First Lady were once being shown an experimental government farm. When Mrs. Coolidge came to the chicken yard, she noticed that one rooster was mating quite frequently. She asked the attendant how often that happened. An attendant told her, "Dozens of times each day," Mrs. Coolidge said. "Tell that to the president when he comes by." When Mr. President came, he was told this, and upon being told, the president asked, "Same hen every time?" The reply was, "Oh no, Mr. President, a different hen every time." President said in a calm voice, "Now tell that to Mrs. Coolidge." Did it actually happen? We are not sure, but this joke appeared in a 1972 book, Aggression in Man and Animals, and became quite famous to an extent that later a biological phenomena was given the name of Coolidge Effect. In 1956, an experiment took place for the first time. A male rat was placed in a large box. Four or five female rats were also introduced in the box. The male rat immediately began to mate with all the female rats repeatedly until he eventually became exhausted. The females continued nudging and licking him, yet he did not respond. Then a novel female rat was introduced in that large box. As soon as it was put in the box, male rat became active again and began mating with the new female rat. They kept on bringing new female rats, and male rat kept on mating until the point of death-like exhaustion. This experiment helped biologists reach a conclusion about sexual attitude of male species. Sexual interest of male begins to decline for a same partner after some episodes of copulation. And male species usually find a renewed interest in novel and new female sexual partners. This male response or sexual attitude was called Coolidge Effect in later years. It was repeated with other male mammals, and all of them represented near same result. This experiment was performed for female species as well, but this novelty loving attitude was seen mostly among male species. Scientists explain there's a biological reason. After all, men mating with more individuals increases the likelihood of procreation and reproduction. And our human brains are inherently programmed to procreate and have more variety in offspring. This is the genetic program, and all of it happens in brain. In earlier times, Coolidge effect may have had less relevance in practical life of individuals. In most historical cultures, men could marry more than once. People could also definitely divorce and marry someone else because of the attractions and desires, and that was the extent of it. Men still needed an effort to go through the modus operandi of their times to have a new partner. But with the modern world, and especially technology at hand, situation has become critical. To add salt to the wounds, adult content online has made matters worse by making access easy to virtual world of nudity. Adult content exploit this subconscious urge of novelty of male brain and continuously feed their viewers newer and aggressive content. That means it is something way beyond we have encountered during evolution. Though virtually, now a male has access to more female novelty than all of his ancestors put together. Each time a male views a new content, this releases the dopamine in the brain. Dopamine is released in the brain when a person expects a reward or something good. When you come to associate a certain activity with pleasure, mere anticipation may be enough to raise dopamine levels. We may go to a restaurant and anticipate eating a new burger or a new dessert. It releases the dopamine in our brains. This can be a case for your new favorite Marvel movie coming, or when you plan to buy your favorite car. This is also true about mating or sexual desire. Dopamine may peak in case of sex or masturbation right at the time of orgasm. This ends up turning into a never-ending loop. Men's biological desire to view something novel or extreme makes them consume more and more adult content. Each time a person clicks on a new video while watching adult content, a big squirt of dopamine is released and cause excess of it in brain, and the cycle goes on. right balance of dopamine in brain is absolutely necessary for a human to work efficiently. The damages of excess of dopamine can be known with the following experiment. A rat is taken and put into a box, and a lever is also attached in the box. Rat would go closer to the lever and push it. Each time rat pushes the lever, his favorite snack would be given to him. A rat would keep pushing the lever 1,000 times in an hour and would keep getting a snack. Later, let's say rat's head is attached to an electrode. This electrode goes to the reward circuitry in rat's brain and it is attached to the lever. Whenever a rat would put its paws on lever, it just sends necessary voltage to stimulate the reward circuitry of rat. A rat will keep pushing the lever to have a rush of dopamine and have its reward circuitry stimulated, and would forget to eat, have sex, even take care of its kids. This attitude is similar to the drug or other substance addicts. Now, some other rats are taken and dopamine neurotoxin is injected into them to block their dopamine production in the brain. These rats will show no interest in pressing the lever. They would even show no motivation to get up for food. If food was put into their mouth, they would eat it, but they would have no interest in doing any effort to get food. They are all the recorded experiments which shows the need of having right balance of dopamine in our bodies. Another experiment with the monkeys were done. But let me ask you first, would you pay to see some hot stuff? No, it's not a question out of blue, because monkeys will. An experiment with a male monkey took place in 2005. First, he was given the juice boxes, the kind he liked. Then the monkey was put in front of screen and pictures of female monkey bottoms were played. Monkey showed a great interest and continued to watch those pictures and even kept on exchanging the juice boxes for those. It's like paying for an adult magazine or some adult website subscription. For a dopamine rush, monkey gave it up all. Both the rat and monkey attitude is not very different from that of drug or substance addicts. And it just shows how our brain need balanced amount of dopamine to function properly. We need proper amount of it to go get up from our beds, have a happy mood, meet people, do new activities, follow our passions and ambitions. So just balance everything, eat healthy, exercise, meditate, do things in moderation and you're good. Now if you like this informative piece, please subscribe to our channel and share with us in comments what you want to see next.